honest. I just don't know. Sometimes I feel like I'm just standing on a cliff. Either I'm gonna fall off, or somebody's gonna push me.
John, I've known you for quite a long time. Your dad was a good friend of mine. You're at a very important place in your life right now, and the direction you take here will affect you for the rest of your life. You know, it's been hard, but we're going to help you. Never question what your purpose in this world is. There are people who care about you, who depend on you. Don't forget that.
Private property.
My mistake.
You new around here or something?
Not really.
Then you should know that this is our block.
What are you cooking up there?
That's none of your business.
Word of advice. I can smell that from a mile away. You should be more careful.
It's me. Look, I know I'm the last person you want to talk to, but I'm sure we can work something out. Just, can I take you out after the final?
Hello?
Hi, Johnny.
Hey, sis. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing all right. School's been tough. And there's some people here who have been pretty irritating.
Things haven't exactly been a party around here either.
Here's the thing, though. I'm coming home in a couple of weeks. And I need a place to stay. I hate to do this to you, but it's not like, you know.
You have parents eagerly awaiting your return? I'm sorry, that wasn't called for. I've got a room here that I haven't decided what to do with yet. You're more than welcome to use it. It'd make a great studio for you.
I'll be home next Sunday.
Hello? This is John. I'll be there.
Mr. Eisman, thank you so much for coming down here. I'm impressed with your resume, and you clearly know how to hold your ground.
Really?
I'll have to clear it with upstairs, but I personally think you'd make an excellent addition to our team.
Thank you.
I'll give you a call next week.
What have you been doing lately?
Nothing much. Just trying to find a job.
Yeah, it was really hard to find something at college. I was so busy. I guess life is crazy like that sometimes.
No, it's unfair.
Are you alright, John?
Why do you ask?
I haven't heard from you much since I left. Why didn't you return my calls?
I've just been really busy, you know, finishing up college and taking care of the house. You know what? Let's go for a walk. For old time's sake.
Same as you were. You've got to decide what to do with the turmoil inside of you. I can help you with that.
Sierra, you're all I have left for family. And I know you want what's best for me, but I gotta figure this out on my own.
But I want to help you. You don't have to figure this out
on your own. Sierra, I don't want to talk about it.
Let's go home.
He was sober. Two
that?
Mitch Peterson. He's from college. Took me out for coffee.
You went out with him?
Only once.
Once was enough?
Yeah.
job opportunity just got filled. Just when things started going right for a change.
John, don't do this to yourself. You're a good person and a hard worker. Something will come up.
I know. I just wonder why me sometimes. Left us here in our grief.
I'm not denying how hard it's been. I think about them every day and can't remember a night when I haven't cried myself to sleep. But I trust that God has a perfect plan, and I've let Him comfort me. You can't live like this, John. No one can.
Well, gentlemen, that's 125 for each and every one of you. Plus the jewelry from that one guy.
Boy, it was desperate. He didn't even know what it was worth.
Mitch, come get your share. Mitch?
You.
Shut up!
Listen, I don't know who you are or what you want, but I swear if you harm her, you won't get out of here alive.
I said shut up!
Why are you doing this?
Because she's mine.
She barely even knows you.
Just let her come with me and no one gets hurt.
That's not gonna happen.
Drop it!
No!
about half an hour ago. The victim was airlifted out. Suspect still at large.
It's gonna be a long day.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an imminent threat to public safety. Last night, this woman, Sarah Eisman, was shot by her brother, John Eisman. According to a witness, he exited his house with an unlicensed gun and led her to the garage. As far as we know, only one shot was fired.
Where is he now?
Well, that's where the trail gets confusing. John's car is missing. But the witness saw a car stop in front of John's house.
We have to go now. Move!
The witness could not identify the driver. Eisman has a 3-hour lead on us, so it suggests you get busy. Questions? Alright, let's get this guy.
What a fool I am. Came in here and spat in the face of God. You know what? I'm not ready yet. I've still got one thing I gotta do. I'm gonna kill Mitch. I'm gonna kill Mitch! That's right. You don't listen to me. You never listen to me! Just try and stop me. Do it! Do it! Do it! A loving God doesn't let innocent people die. Forget about God. It's just you and me.
What were you thinking?
All I had to do was get the girl quietly.
The cops? They're gonna be coming.
Shut up! Let me think.
Did you kill her?
No, I... The gun went off! It was an accident!
What about the other guy?
I don't know.
He's gonna be coming for you.
I know! I know. And I'll deal with him, just like we do with everyone else.
You better. But first, we have to move, because this is the first place he's gonna look. He's seen me, he's seen you.
Yeah. wouldn't do that if I were you.
I'm sorry, is this yours?
No. Never touch the stuff. But if my mommy would say, you don't know where that's been. So you, headed somewhere? Family?
Not anymore.
Hey, excuse me. What do you think?
Hey, that's right where I'm going. Let's go.
Get out of my car.
Oh, no. I gotta keep an eye on you.
Oh, what are you, cop?
Oh, you saw right through me. I'm off of... Nah, I'm just a guy. Hey, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
No, I mean...
Buddy, get out of my car.
Or what? You shoot me?
Look, I've got some business that I need.
Business with that gun?
Forget about the gun! Okay? Get out of my car!
I'm not gonna get out till I know you're safe.
Alright, where do you need to go?
Wherever you're going.
Right.
Hey, you got a name?
No.
Come on.
John.
Caleb. Let's roll.
It's John's gun, all right.
You don't honestly think he would kill his own sister?
I know something horrific happened last night, and that John Eisman is nowhere to be found.
Yeah, well, he hasn't exactly been successful lately. Look at this. His parents died in a car accident 3 years ago. He's been clinically diagnosed with depression. He's been rejected by 3 companies in the past 2 weeks, and his girlfriend just broke up with him. His world is collapsing around him.
Any immediate family? All right, let's go talk with her.
So, not much of a talker then, eh?
Look, buddy. I agreed to take you with me, not to talk to you.
Mind if I turn the radio?
Sure.
Last night that this was not a pretty scene. Let's go now live to the police department.
This is Rick Owens, supervisor for the Pierce County Law Enforcement. On behalf of the state, I am issuing an arrest warrant for Mr. John Eisman, the lead suspect in a local homicide that occurred approximately 0100 hours Saturday. Anyone with knowledge on his whereabouts is requested to come to our headquarters immediately. The entire southeastern residential area is on lockdown until we have Mr. Eisman in our custody. Subject is armed and considered extremely dangerous.
Great.
So, wanna talk about it?
Alright. I'm the guy they're talking about. A few nights ago, my sister's ex came to my house. Must have mistaken me for her new boyfriend or something. Pointed a gun at me and I got the chance to jump him, but then he... Gun...
I think I know what happened.
Sarah was the only family I had left. Now she's gone too.
So what are you gonna do?
What am I gonna do? What do you think?
I think you should put that gun down and go home.
I didn't really know John that well. He never really had a steady girlfriend, and to be honest, our first date was more my idea than his. Ever since I've known him, he just seems distant. Oh, not that I would think he would ever kill anyone. You see, John is a great guy, and he's just...
Miss Hand, I'm going to be frank.
I don't know what's going on. I don't know why John did what he did. We're interested in the public safety, and I can't guarantee anyone around John is safe.
I'll do whatever you need, but I want John to have a fair trial, of course. Who exactly was the victim? John, what have you done?
Here we go, people.
This is a terrible idea. John could have gotten a weapon.
She's on her way.
It's too late now.
Gosh, John, don't scare me like that.
Doing here?
Tell me it isn't true.
Of course not. It was Mitch.
Who?
Mitch Peterson. Someone Sarah met in college. Somehow he found out where I lived and must have mistaken me for a boyfriend or something.
Why? Why would he?
How should I know? They weren't even dating.
What are you gonna do?
What do you think?
John, why didn't you tell me about your parents?
Why didn't you tell me we were through, that you found somebody else?
Well, I called things off because I thought you didn't like me.
Last time I checked, people in a relationship at least try to work things out.
There's something you're not telling me.
Something is very wrong here.
Just let it play. We can have officers over there in a minute.
Do you trust me, Lily?
Honestly, I can't keep seeing you. I feel like I'm not being heard.
So there is someone else.
John, it's over. My father always said we can't keep running.
This is not going well at all.
John, maybe we could...
There is no we anymore. I have to see this through by myself. Lily, you gotta get away from these people.
They're just trying to help. They'll discover it wasn't you.
These people are crazy. They definitely don't have my best intentions in mind.
John, they're cops. They just want justice.
Right. A cop who had sent an innocent young woman in alone with a homicide suspect. This is all the information I can find on Mitch. If they ask where I'm going, tell them I'm headed west into downtown. Got it?
John, they'll discover it wasn't you.
I can't chance that. Not until I... I'm sorry.
helicopter. I want him found.
Put the snipers in place. Permission to kill on sight.
That is not necessary.
He just shot at his ex.
You put her in place as bait? You can't just do something like that.
You're under arrest for assault and attempted murder.
You heard me back there. I was set up.
Lay down your armor or we will open
fire.
Do you
honestly think I would kill the only person I have left?
Mr. Eisman, you have the right to
Why
remain
don't
silent.
You just shut the...
Anybody, Mitch, we gotta go. Do yourself a favor and leave me alone.
We're in no shape to continue this chase.
I agree. Fall back to mobile command.
Sometimes I feel like I'm just standing on a cliff. Either I'm gonna fall off, or somebody's gonna push me.
Don't ever question what your purpose in this world is.
My purpose.
there, and I ain't planning on going down after you.
It doesn't matter. No one was hurt.
He had a gun! We should have never sent her over there!
There is no other way to get the information that we needed.
You know damn well what risk we took. Sending in a civilian to confront a homicide suspect? And above all, you send in the ex-girlfriend!
This isn't helping the investigation. Where's Miss Hand?
I dismissed her.
What?
She gave us this. There's a new wrench in our case.
It's BS. He's hiding something.
Sir, you saw those two today. They obviously have some problem between them. We have to find them both if we're going to figure out what happened that night. We still don't know—
What more do you want? John has been having mental problems. His gun had fingerprints all over it. I can't arrest John, so I sure as heck am not going to arrest anyone else because my subordinate has a hunch. I'm in charge here, and we're going after John Eisman.
How did you get here?
Followed the police.
And they didn't see you?
They're not looking for me. Are you okay there?
It'll be fine.
Good. Because that's the least of your problems. Do you know how deep you're digging yourself here?
Look, can you cut me some slack? It's not too late for me to dump you.
Has it occurred to you that I might be here to help you?
You did a fine job of that when I was chasing Mitch.
Has it occurred to you that killing Mitch might not be such a good idea?
Has it occurred to you that I just got shot at and I don't want to talk about it? Look, I appreciate the company, I really do. But you're just along for the ride. I give up one last thing I need to do in life, and I can drop you off wherever you need to before I...
Has it occurred to you there might be some other purpose in your life other than just killing Mitch?
Before my parents died, I thought I had it all figured out.
Sometimes, God changes our plans.
It's all of it, Chris. Excellent.
Beautiful, ain't it?
I still don't know what to make of you. They'll still be following us. We should keep moving. We need to head northwest. Greensboro's where Mitch is from. It's about a day's walk from here.
Are you sure you want to go through with this?
Mitch is hiding in the woods near Greensboro.
Not listening to me. Not going after Mitch.
But I know where he is. And Eisman does too.
I want a squad ready in 5, heavily armed. You better not be screwing with me.
We're just outside Greensboro. We must be close.
Where is it? Where's what? $5,000.
You lost $5,000?
I gave it.
No, you didn't. It was worth the $30,000.
It doesn't matter. Shut up.
You shut up.
What are you doing? Come on, let's go. Mitch needs to pay for what happened.
If this is something you have to do, you're on your own.
Listen to me, Caleb. My sister is dead. God has abandoned me. I need Mitch to know my pain.
Now I've done you a lot of favors. Do this one for me, okay? I asked God to stop me. I dared him to stop me. And you know what? He didn't listen to me. He doesn't answer me. He doesn't know me.
But he does know you. He loves you. He's working faithfully.
You can never understand. I can't accept that. I can't accept that he has this perfect plan when he lets my sister die for no reason. He let innocent people die for no reason.
And yet, you're willing to go down there and kill a man who's just as confused and just as hurt as you are. You think God doesn't show up in your perfect world? Life's not perfect. Life's messy. Life's complicated. And it is in that messy, complicated life that's where God shows up.
Mitch doesn't deserve a second chance, okay?
Who does deserve a second chance?
Sometimes you have to fight to be a man. Drop it!
Hands in the air.
Sarah never told me she had a boyfriend back home.
So what, you were gonna just kill her because she had a date?
Who are you?
I'm her brother.
I didn't mean anything that night. I was half drunk and, well, when I saw you with her, I put two and two together.
That doesn't justify what happened.
So why are you here? You're here to kill me? Will you?
I haven't decided yet.
Why wouldn't you?
Sarah's not coming back. I can yell, curse, and kill anybody, but Sarah's not coming back. You've done a terrible thing, and you're gonna have to live with that.
Well, I would love to stay chit-chat about who killed who, but the police have arrived.
You come with me, you tie him up.
Get out.
What are you gonna do?
Give him a well-deserved welcome. I never wanted any of this.
It's too late for that.
In position over there.
They're just doing their jobs. They don't want to hurt you. Don't kill anyone if you don't have to.
Order, officer?
Yes, it is.
I seem to remember giving you strict anatomical directions on where you can stick your orders.
Tell your men to lay down your arms.
Well, it's been fun, officer. But I think it's time for you to leave.
Not on your life.
Chris, it's over. Let's get out while we can.
Your position is surrounded. Surrender.
Well, if that's the way it's gonna be...
Owen, stop. You don't need to do this with violence.
Open fire!
can't hold out much longer. Take the van. Grab as much of this stuff as you can. I'll find you, and then we start. No! We've got to be done with this. Listen to me. We will get through this.
Well, what about him?
Kill him!
Give me one reason I shouldn't kill you right now!
Just do it! I don't deserve to live! I saw in Sarah something I hadn't seen in other girls. I saw in her life. I don't live an honest life. I never have and I never will. No one will miss me. Just pull the trigger. Do it! Do it!
No. No. Everybody deserves a second chance.
You're under arrest.
Officer, I understand how this looks.
Save it.
I'm not associated with these people.
Yeah, I've heard that too many times.
No, but not have it work. Stop this, Rick!
Choke. I'm sorry. I didn't want this. Forgive me. It caused you so much pain. And I can't do anything to fix it.
Oh, I killed you, Mitch. I don't care what other people think. I'm not gonna live that way anymore. I'm just as guilty as you.
I didn't want it to end like this.
Were you here to kill him? I don't blame you. I probably would have too.
It doesn't make it right.
Yeah.
So you expect us to believe that you're innocent?
This is the gun I took with me the night I left. It's Mitch's gun. I left my own behind.
Could you come with us? We've got some questions to ask you.
Of course.
Mr. Eisman, there are some things we need to discuss about your sister.
Oh. Mom would have wanted her to be buried. I have a little bit of money saved up, but...
John. Sarah's still alive.
What?
She's at the hospital right now. She's hanging in there.
Can I see her?
Right away. Shimani?
Sarah. I'm here. I'll always be here. I'm so sorry.
It's so dark. John, will I ever see again? Where's Mitch?
He's dead.
You didn't kill him, did you?
I wanted to, but I just couldn't take the shot. He ended up saving my life. It's a long story. Let's just say I've changed.
I'm so glad, Johnny. I guess art is out of the question now.
You still have two working hands and something of a brain. I'll be right back.
Johnny, don't leave me, please.
I'm here for you, Sarah. I just got something I gotta do first. Just say it. Say it!
That's not why I'm here. I finished my report on the Eisman case.
It has no longer come to me. I talked with my superiors. They want me gone. I'm sending in my resignation immediately.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir. You've been a great...
Don't patronize me. We both know what you want.
Sir, please don't think that I would be so rude as to...
My reputation is ruined. Besides, the department wasn't big enough for the both of us anyway.
I always thought Sarah was crazy for letting go of our parents' death. But I realized that bad things happen for a reason. And as hard as it can be, we need to let our despair go. Evil and misery will still exist in this world. But in the end, it only leads to destruction. The hurt never fully leaves. It is something we may have to carry for the rest of our lives. It is almost too much to bear. But there's one who can carry it, who stands with open arms. It's
took everything away from me. My parents, my sister, and nearly my life. I had one last desire, and even that you wouldn't give to me. You showed me anger and revenge. Can't bring life. And Caleb helped me see that you really do care about my pain. And no matter what happens, I can always come back to you. I've learned a lot on this journey, but I think the most important lesson is that fighting isn't the answer.
I asked Sarah where you were.
Why?
Because last time we met wasn't under ideal circumstances.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. I knew there would be risks.
No, not that. I've been so foolish. I know what you want, and I don't deserve you. I've been so selfish.
John,
and...
just stop. Do you trust me?
Even if the storms never stop, even if the violence never ceases, even if the pain stays relentless, you have to forgive to be a man.